Hello friends, today we'll gonna see design of compression member. A little brief introduction about myself Quazi, Syed, Shujat, Ali, currently working as assistant professor in civil engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. The learning outcome of this session is, at the end of this session, students will be able to design the members which are subjected to axial compression. What is compression member? Basically, the member which is generally subjected to compressive force is nothing but compression member. So this is a definition of compression member. Members which are primarily subjected to compressive force are nothing but compression members. This diagram represents one, there is one short column and another one is long column. What is mean by short column? A column whose slenderness ratio is less than 12. And what is long column? The column whose slenderness ratio is greater than 12. Basically, short column will fail by crushing and long column will fail by buckling. Now we'll see there are various nomenclatures for the compression members. The same member which carries the vertical compressive force in building is called as columns or posts. The same compression member in trusses is called as struts. The same compression member in words of crane is called as boom. How to select the shape of compression member? We'll select the member in such a way that we'll get the maximum moment of inertia. Ideally, for the same cross sectional area, the circular sections are the best sections. After that, we are having square tubing. After that, we are having rectangular section. So for the design of beams, we'll select an I section, and for the design of struts, the members which carry compressive force in trusses are nothing but the struts, we'll select single angle section as well as double angle section, either of the two, but we'll select the equal single angles because we'll get same radius of gyration along both the axis. Ideally, the member for same cross sectional area is the best is our pipe section, because we are getting the maximum moment of inertia for the pipe section. But due to the difficulty in connection, and because we get some difficulty in connecting this pipe section, we'll select square tubing or rectangular tubing. But due to the advancement in welding nowadays, we can select these sections suitably. Now, how to select the effective length of compression member? This table is given in IS 800 2007. It is given in table number 11. So for different boundary conditions, we are having the different values of effective length. At one end, we are having translational restraint, rotational restraint. At the other end, we are having translational restraint free, rotation free. This represents a one end fixed, other end free type of that column whose effective length will be equal to 2L. Okay. Next, we'll see the design steps for compression members. The following are the usual steps in the design of compression member. First of all, we'll assume the design stress in the compression member. Then we'll calculate effective sectional area. Now, how to calculate effective sectional area? It is given by the formula, that is, area will be equal to load divided by stress. The load will be given to us. We'll get the value of load, and we'll assume the that design stress, and with the help of this we'll calculate area. Then we'll select a section from IS handbook number 1 and we'll calculate the value of R minimum. Okay. Then depending upon the boundary conditions, we'll calculate the effective length, and by the use of this effective length and this R minimum, we'll calculate slenderness ratio, KL by R. General formula for slenderness ratio is KL by R. KL is the effective length and R is the radius of gyration. Then we get the value of this slenderness ratio. With the help of this slenderness ratio, by using the IS table number 9 A, B, C, depending upon the buckling class, we'll calculate the value of design stress, and with the help of this design stress, we'll calculate the value of the load carrying capacity of the section. Then if the load carrying capacity is less than the factored load, that is the given load, our section means our section fails. Or if the load carrying capacity is very much higher than this design load, the section will become uneconomical, then we have to revise the section. This is how we have to assume the slenderness. This is how we have to assume the design stress. Depending upon the slenderness ratio for the angle struts, the value is assumed to be around 90 MPa. We'll see a small numerical example for the design, so that we'll get a clear understanding of the design of compression member. The question is, design a single angle strut connected to the gusset plate to carry 180 kN factored load. The length of the strut between center to center connection is 3 meter. Given the data is goes somewhat like this. We have given the single angle section, then we have given the factored load. After that, we have given the support condition. Center to center connection is 3 meter. Basically, first of all, we'll assume the value of FCD, which is equal to 90 MPa. Then with the help of this FCD, we'll calculate the area required, which is equal to 180 kN divided by the stress. We'll get around 2000 mm square. With the help of IS handbook number 1 or the steel table, we'll select a suitable angle section. Here I have selected 90 by 90 by 12, which is having an area of 2019 mm square. From that I got the value of RVV, which is equal to 17.4 mm. For the continuous member, we'll get the value of effective length will be equal to 0.85L, which is equal to 0.85 into 3000, which is equal to 2550 mm. This is given in IS 800-2007 for the angle strut. Then we calculate the value of slenderness ratio. This effective length divided by R will get the value of slenderness ratio. Now, by the use of this IS table number 9C, we'll get the value of FCD. Basically, we are using single angle section, that's why we are using the buckling class C. This is given in IS table number 10, which buckling class we have to select. Then we get the value of FCD, which is equal to 61.62 MPa. Then we'll calculate PD, which is equal to A into FCD, but this value comes out to be less than 180. Then we have to revise the section. Now we'll select some higher sections. We'll try here 130 by 130 by 8. We have this area, we have this RVV, we get slenderness ratio, similar steps. Now the value of FCD as per table number 9C of IS 800-2007 equal to 107 newton per mm square. The carrying capacity, load carrying capacity, is equal to 216 kN, which is greater than 180 kN. Therefore, it is safe. Now these are some review questions. You can pause the video and answer these questions. The answers for the questions are yes. Okay. So these are my references. Thank you.